Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. The Pacific is well known for its sports stars in international fields like rugby union, league, netball, and the list goes on.
But in Samoa this month, history was made as the island nation held its inaugural half-iron triathlon. As John Paulo discovers, it didn't take long for the locals to shine in this very competitive sport.
They ran in numbers. They swam a challenging distance. They race in tough conditions. This is the Samoa Half Iron Challenge. The bustling streets of Apia come to a halt as some special visitors march through town. But they aren't ordinary tourists who come for a bit of sightseeing. These athletes from around the globe are here to compete.
It is a new market for us as a tourism destination. We're saying to the world, we have the climate, and we have a natural opportunity between April and October, when it's cold down in New Zealand and so on, come and play.
Their playground is here in Upolu, where these 65 competitors will compete in a half-iron triathlon. The event consists of a 2-kilometre swim, 90-kilometre bike ride, and a 21-kilometre run. The bet that's brought these triathletes together is the grand prize money worth 6,000 New Zealand dollars for the first man and woman to finish. Geared up and ready to go are the Nimarota brothers from the village of Leosoali'i in Upolu. This is the first time the local teens have ever taken part in this kind of sport, but it hasn't fazed them from representing their island. For elder brother Sam Nimarota, their training regime has been tough, but it's their family support that's kept them going.
Come on, Sam, from our sister. First, in mga awala ko eh, mua ma ua. Mewala liya maki fi, nga ua ya iso si makalong. Ya karim mang nga osi mako ay nga. Mewala nga maki fi fi oleo me support ma ua. Lang olang ngul kele uke mo makalong.
It's D-Day, and in the darkness of up here, the triathletes gather to prepare for what is going to be an historic day in Samoa.
Of time of silly year.
As the sun opens a new day, the athletes hop into the cool water and begin the tough 2-kilometre swim. First to hop out of the water is one of the elite swimmers, but there's no sign of the Nimarota brothers. Suddenly, Sam Nimarota appears. He quickly rushes to his bike while trying to recover from his swim. His dad, Tupai Nimarota, is right by the sideline to cheer him on. We follow the cyclist along the east coast out of Apia. It's an exhausting length to cycle with potential dangers as they're riding on open road amongst the traffic and some of the local pets. But the villagers are right there to give them a push. With most of the competitors well on their way back to town, Sam soldiers on, unaware his younger brother Steve has pulled out due to a flat tyre. In the final leg of the race, we're back in Apia, where the competitors are just hanging on to finish the race. For some, it meant running barefoot just to reach the finish line. One by one, the athletes crossed the line, and soon it was Sam's turn, accompanied by his younger brother. For the organisers, it's a success for the inaugural event, and it certainly won't be the last.
Yes, I'd love to see a half Ironman become an annual event for Samoa. It all comes down to dollars and cents. And, you know, it's when I put it out there last year, So I certainly was told not to handle it because it's just too costly. But I've gone ahead, I put a stake in the ground and I've made it happen. So I am hoping that we can repeat this next year and the year after.
And our crew even got into the spirit of things by attempting their very own short course.
I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win.